Alright. What is a wild rag? I did one video on a wild rag using it as a face sheet. If you search my videos, it'll say something about a wild rag using it as a fly sheet for a horse. And now I want to talk about a couple of knots. Mainly the Buckaroo, the four square knot. I don't know if you can see this knot here. Is that coming in pretty clear? Let me move in closer here. Okay, that's a four square knot. One, two, three, four. It's got four squares. This is called the old Buckaroo knot. And again, on my website, I'm going to put a link. If you go to the description area on the YouTube, I'll have a link to my website. I got a picture and it shows a diagram. But I just kind of want to talk about some of the uses for wild rags. And a wild rag is the same thing as a cowboy bandana. It's also called a neckerchief. It's called a wild rag. It's a silk scarf. Most of them are 100% silk. This is a little bit thicker. I think they call it a charmise or charmeuse. Somebody will correct me, I'm sure. But if you go to, I've got three links on my scarf, and again, I'll have it linked on my scarf page, or the scarf area, on where you can order these. I've got three places listed. They sell all these. I bought these at different places. This is a very thin one. This is, I can see through it. I can actually see through this. So this is a lightweight. I use this in summer. This is a charmeuse or charmeuse also. It's a little bit thicker. You can't see through it, but it's warmer in the winter. This is a thin one. So a wild rag, what are they for? Why do cowboys, or why in the Old West, if you see an old movie or something, you always see a guy with a scarf around his neck. Why is that? Because it's functional as hell. When you're out in the middle of nowhere, these scarves are great. Silk is a natural fiber. It takes sweat off my neck. So when I'm sweating, as the wind blows through here, it actually cools me in the summer. However, in the winter, this morning it was nippy. When this was around me, it kept the draft and the cold from going down on my shirt. It kept the breeze and the wind, so it kept me warm. So they'll keep you warm in the morning, and then later on in the afternoon, I've got this tied around my neck. This is one way to tie it. I'm gonna take it off here. And if I got hot and I was riding, I might just swing it across my neck like that, because then the wind would blow it. It keeps the flies off. It keeps me cool. As I'm waving this right now, I feel the cool wind. And again, it's silk, natural fiber. If I need to wash something, I can use it as a sling. If I hurt my arm, it becomes a sling. If I need to carry something, you can tie it what's called the old hobo bag. You tie it in half, shove something in it, and then you tie the corners together and you tie it right on your saddlebag, and it becomes a sack to carry stuff. So it comes in handy for that. If the sun, I've got them all tied up, I think. I wanted to untie them and show you how to tie them here. Should be okay. Another good thing about that four square Buckaroo knot is it comes untied easy. So this is a scarf. Okay, silk scarf. Got a pretty design. Oh, look, Rick, how pretty. When it's around your neck, nobody really cares. But they sell them with all kind of different styles. The most common way to fold it is kind of just in a diamond catacorner, and then hang it over your neck there, and then tie it around your neck. And then a couple ways to tie it is, again, I have several demonstrations on my website, is basically just an overhand knot that comes straight over like this, and then I'm going to take this and do another overhand knot, and there's my scarf knot. So that's one for just hanging right there. That's just a simple, I think they call it a square knot. If you want a slip knot, you can tie it like a tie. Basically all I do is I wrap it around once, and then I come back around through the top, straight down here, and it becomes a slip knot. Okay, there's another way to tie a slip knot, and then I can tie that up and tighten it when I want to. If I want to loosen it, I can loosen it. Okay, if I get in a dust storm, I want to turn it around, I can put this over my face, and then I can tighten it up on one of the titans. And then it tightens up to keep the dust out of my face. If I'm riding, the sun's in my face and it's burning me, I can put this up as a sunblock. It keeps it off my neck. It keeps the sun off me. It's making my sunglasses fog up because all my hot air is going in there. But yeah, that's right. Okay, ladies, go ahead. Yeah, he's full of hot air. Yeah, okay, that's what I said. So, again, that's a slip knot. That's one way to tie it. Another way to tie a slip knot is just basically an overhand knot, to where I'm going to show you now. Is if I want to tie another slip knot, I simply take this and I just tie a simple knot, one over. Okay, pretty easy. But I keep my fingers through there. Then I take this, I slide that through, and then I tighten that knot. Now I have a slip knot. That's another way to tie it. So they're pretty simple. They're pretty easy to tie. Again, the four square buckaroo knot is what's going to be on the title of this. If the sun's on my face sometimes, what I will do is I will actually just, depending on whether I have a cowboy hat or how much sun is on me, I will just drape this over my head and then throw my hat on. And now if I'm riding back, that's going to keep the flies, it'll keep mosquitoes off me. If it's a little bit nippy and cold out, I can wrap this around, it'll keep me warm. If I'm going in a close area or I get in the shade, the wind starts blowing. Again, sunblock keeps the sun off my neck and inside, keeps the wind off me. There's just so many uses for this. It can be a flag to signal somebody if you're lost. You can sack out your horses. See, buddy, paying attention to me? So, I mean, these scarves are so useful. It's just amazing. And you'll rarely see me out there without one. Again, this is the four square. I spilled coffee on this morning, so I had to wash it real quick. It's already dried. Again, silk dries really quick. You can get it wet and it dries. If I'm on a hot day, I'll take this off, stick it in a water bucket, throw it on my neck, wipe my face down, wipe my horse's face down, throw it on my neck, and the wind blows through that whelk silk and it just cools me off. Really, really good. Four square knot. Let's talk about a couple ways to tie this. Can you see the time on there? How much time we got?
Six.
6 minutes? Oh, okay, we're doing good. Four square knot. I always think I'm in a hurry. That's okay. There's a couple ways to tie it. I've seen a couple videos on YouTube. I didn't really like them. Didn't think they explain it well. But here's one way. You take it and you just wrap it around here once. Now what I've done is I've made two squares. Here's one bar and two bars. And then basically you put this under this and then you circle back around and now you can see the three squares developing. One, two, three. So now I need to make my fourth square here. I'm going to come on top and through this little hole here. And that's my four square. And you can see the four squares as I pull and tighten up. And there's my four square. That's one way to tie it. The way I normally tie it, and again, I can tie this when it's off me to make it look neat or pretty. I mean, you can fold this and make it look nice and square. The other way I tie it is I take this across and I just loop it through that. So basically I have one of my bars right there. And then I stick this finger here, I go over it, there's two. I come down, there's my three. And then I take this loose end that I'm holding and I just stick it through this hole. And then there's my four square. And then I tighten that, tighten that, tighten that, tighten that, tighten that. And there's my four square knot. A buckaroo knot kind of shows tradition, the old traditional West. People who took pride in how they dress and how they look, they'd make their buckaroo knot look nice. You can get it higher, you can get it lower. And again, I'm going to do it a couple times because no matter how many times you do it, it's hard to explain. I'm going to take this scarf and I just fold it over like that. Okay? So this is going to be my last one that I run through. Then I stick my finger here to make my loop that I'm going to be running this through. I come up and around. There's my third square. Now I keep this hole here because this has got to come through it. And I just take this and I run that through that. And there's my four square. And that's how I tie it. I'm sure there's another way if you want to sit around and tie it different ways. I like a four square because, again, it comes untied easy. You can make it bigger if you want to. If I wanted to tie this up and make it look nice and fluffy, I could leave it kind of fluffy. The girls may like the fluffy one. Oh, Rick, that's so cute. The guys may like, because they want to crank it down and, my gosh, show it who's boss. So they may like it tighter. But a four square knot, and again, if I need to get this off, I can just take it off. Okay? So I can tie this knot later, and then when I want to put it on, it's already tied. I don't have to tie it around my neck. So you can sit around and practice this with a rope. I'll show you the other way, the twist one that people do. Again, it's you come across here like this. What I normally do when I'm doing this one is I come under and around instead of holding that, and then you just circle right back around to the hole. And there's my four square. So, now, again, a lot of people will tell you the best way to tie this when you want it off your neck in the wind is you get the triangle, you put it around your neck, you come across your back, you put this one over this way, and then you put this side over this way, and then you take your two ends and you tie it right here. And you tie a little square knot or whatever you want. And this is the most probably common way. And then I tuck my collar over the top just to keep the wind out. This is probably the most common way. But to me, trying to tie this in a blind is kind of a pain. You can't really see your knot. You don't know what it is. So what I do is I measure on how tight I want this. And I usually don't want it too tight because I have to get it loose. So I know my knot's got to be about right here. And that's for my scarf, okay? So I want my knot right here. So now what I do is I take this off, keeping my knot. Oh, that sun's bright. And now I'm going to tie my knot right here. So I'm going to tie me a nice little four square knot here. Come around here. Come around there. So there's my little four square knot that I have tied right there. Now I can do the same scarf knot that I was doing by simply getting my scarf here, putting it around my neck. In the back, I just cross it, and then I pull that circle back around my head. And my scarf, I'm not tying in the dark, and then I set it up. So when I want to take, I see people want to take their scarf off, and it's like, well, I gotta untie the knot. Like, can you help me? Cause I, look, man, just tighten the stinking scarf up and pull it around your neck, and take the damn thing off. Okay. Then if I want to hang it here, if I want it to get hot, I can do it there. If I get in the shade or a breezy area, I get down a valley, it gets kind of cool, and I want to warm it up a little bit. I spin it around, cross it in the back, bring it over the head, and now I'm back in business. Now again. On my website, I list a whole bunch of things that you can use this. You can use this because it's silk. You can use it as a strainer for dirty water. If you got dirty water with some crap, you want to pour the water through to filter it before you boil it. You can use it, again, to clean, for a bandage. You can use it for a tourniquet, a signal flag. They come in all different colors. This one has a bunch of brands. This is old style branding. I forgot, you'll see it if you go to one of the websites. But they got all the different old brands that used to be on cattle and horses. This is a brand one. This is a cowboy. This is just plain black. I think they call this a lumberjack plaid. So having a silk scarf with you, to me, it kind of shows a little bit for tradition, but it's functional. You can wipe your horse's face. You can get your horse used to it. You can use it as a fly sheet. You can use it for different things that will help you and your horse. So it's kind of like being prepared, having things, you know, again, it's functional. Don't just go out and get your scarf because it looks cool. Learn how to use it in your horsemanship. I can even tie this up and make a set of hobbles. If my horse is hobble trained and I don't have a rope or something, I can tie him around his feet. I can do a quick twist. My horse wanted to hobble, I'd put that around his wrist, whip this around a few times, put his other paw in there, and I'd have a set of hobbles for my horse. Now, is that strong? Would I train a horse this way? No, because he'd just rip it. But my horses are hobble trained, he wouldn't pull, and I'd probably let him walk around like this. So, again, a lot of uses. I list a bunch on the website. I'm sure there's some others out there. I'll put a link in the description area. Silk scarf, cowboy bandana, neckerchief, wild rags, whatever you want to call them. They're handy, they're functional. Highly recommend them, and I got the links to go. I'm not compensated for the links, so pick your place. Buddy, Mr. T, you're a good boy. I'll do that one.